Everyone, welcome to the Unagi Sayaka Watch, where we keep updates on Unagi Sayaka since she went freelancing back in October 22 of 2022, going to various promotions all over Japan, such as Marvelous, Sendai's, Oz Academy, wherever all over Japan she appears, including also the international scenes like GCW, West Coast Pro, and of course RCW Spain. And of course, we keep you guys updates on her upcoming matches and other developments that she's been involved in as well. So, I am your host, Gerard here. So, if you guys are new to the channel, welcome. This is a channel where we do a lot of pro wrestling content involving, of course, videos like this one with Unagi Sayaka, who is a Yoshi wrestler based out of Japan. We also do reviews on various promotions, such as AEW, New Japan, and various other promotions not only here in the United States, but also in Japan, Mexico, Canada, Europe, the UK, anywhere in the world where pro wrestling is not as big, but it continues to grow. We also do discussion videos. We talk about various topics such as the wrestlers themselves, the promotions, factions, storylines, whatever we want to talk about. We also do news updates to keep you guys updated what's been happening in the world of pro wrestling, such as what events the promotions are thrown out, who's booked, what matches are set, developments that are happening in the world of pro wrestling, such as, of course, wrestlers that have been signed, wrestlers who are departing from their promotions, injured wrestlers, wrestlers are having exciting times in their personal life, such as weddings, births, and all that sort of thing. And, of course, we do more news updates, alerts to keep you guys alert on anything that's been happening in the world of pro wrestling. And, of course, videos like this as well. So if you like what you see, please subscribe to us. So click on that subscribe button. You'll be getting videos like these whenever we pop up, or other wrestling content such as the reviews, discussions, and various other cool things as well. But if you like this video, please subscribe to us. So click on that click on the like button, or leave us a nice comment in the description down below. Now, the introductions I've set aside, I think it's time to get the show on the road. So let's begin with Unagi Sayaka's, of course, on her matches and reviews. It's been a while since I did an Unagi Sayaka watch. I apologize to everyone. I've been caught up with all the other things going on. But, however, I finally get this opportunity to do so. There's a long list of wrestling matches that she was involved in. So, bear with me. We may take too much time on this one. First, as you guys know, she made an appearance in Ice Ribbon, where she stirred the pot with, of course, stirred some shizmits up with Miyu Shirai. So, she ended up in a tag match with, of course, Yuki Mashira, who sent her a love call that took on Hamuko Hoshi and Saran. Now, eventually, I saw a clip of that. I did not see the full match of this one. It was Unagi who picked up the win when she applied the flatliner onto Hoshi to win the match. But, of course, it appears that Mashiro wants to put her championship on the line against both Unagi and Mio. So, we'll get to that at some point. Now, our next match, we had a title match. Match for GTO at the GTO Michinoku Super Best 2024. This took place recently on the 5th of May. She put the GTO girls title on the line against her former protege, Aoi. This one was a pretty good match, but of course it was Aoi who picked up the win, getting her first her first big championship match on this one. But, of course, in the end, Unagi gave her a hug for winning this title. Now, she made her, not too long ago, a debut with Oz Academy. She teams up with Mayu Hiki to take on Hakino and Zones. Now, as you all know, Unagi said that she's a fan of Ozaki-gun. But, however, Mayu Hiki is not too keen on her. But she allowed her to team up with her. And, luckily, it was Maya who picked up the win. However, Maya did not allow her to join, that sort of thing. So that kind of went out the window. But there was a match that was announced recently that she was involved in. I did not see it, but I did know it was Mayuhiki versus Unagi. We'll talk about that maybe on the next Unagi Sayaka watch. So we'll get to that at some point. Because I haven't updated. This is like, I kind of like wrote these notes a while back, but I'm getting to this now. Her next match took place in Marvelous in Shinkiba on the 14th. She was involved in a three-way tag match. She had a six-woman tag match on this one. She teams up with Chikayo Nagashima and Isuko Aoki to take on Miyu Momono, Miyuki Takase, and Riko Kawahara. Now, unfortunately, this match ended in a time limit draw of 20 minutes. Did not see this entirety of the match, but yes, that's what took place. Then she appeared in SEAdLINNNG for the Shinkiba series, Volume 3, on May 17th. She teams up with Misa Kagura to take on Suri and Arisa Nakajima. But unfortunately, Nakajima and Suri picked up the win on this one. Now, I did not see the full match on this one, but yeah, that's what happened. Then she appeared in Gambari Pro for the Everything Everywhere at All Once. Took place on the 18th of May. She put her Kitsune Women World title on the line against Yuri. Now, Yuri was the one who nominated herself to challenge for this belt because she wants to take Gambari Pro internationally. But Unagi doesn't think that she's ready for that. So basically, the match was approved. I'm going to say the promoter said it was okay. But of course, Unagi won this match, retaining her belt. So that's what took place. Then she appeared on the 22nd of May at Evolution's Volume 15, where she teams up with Yuna Manase to take on Chi-Chi and Momoka Anozono. Now, Unagi declared war against Evolution because they kicked her out, and she brought her mentor in tow. And she won this match, which is a humiliating loss for Chi-Chi, who is a high prospect in, of course, in the promotion. So that's the reason. Now, she did make two appearances, two back-to-back days, on the 25th and the 26th of May for Fireball Wrestling or something. They're both exploding death matches. The first one took place on the 25th of May. It was an electric explosion, bat coffin explosion, meteor, fire death match. Yeah, that's a long one. She teams up with Almighty Eon and Shadow WX, but they lost that match against Asushi Onita, Hasegawa, and Saki. However, the following day, Unagi actually picked up the win. When she teams up once again with Shadow WX, Rising Kid, defeating, of course, Asushi Onita, Hasegawa, and Saki. Now, on the 30th of May, Unagi made her appearance with Marvelous in Shinkiba, where she defeated, in a three-way match, Maria and Tomoko Watanabe. And then, of course, on the 1st of May in Sapporo, she appeared to face El Kukui, but eventually lost that match. And then finally, on the 2nd of June in Sapporo, she and Misa Kagura eventually ended up in a tag match for the AAW tag team titles to face against Magenta. But unfortunately, they did not win that match. But I feel like this match also showed... Not Misa Kagura, my bad. She teamed up with Brooke Havoc, but they lost the match. Brooke Havoc was the one who eventually lost the match. So that's pretty much what happened in all her matches recently. There will be more developments on this one, so we'll get to that at some point. Right now, let's talk about her upcoming matches. Continue on more with the Unagi Sayaka watch. So we have two upcoming matches later on that we have. The first one, as you know, every year CMLL will be in town with, of course, the Lady Rings, which is an annual event that takes place. And this is a good way where they actually find Japanese wrestlers that want to participate in the upcoming Grand Prix the Amazonias, which is, of course, their versions of the ladies being involved. Unagi will be involved in a title match on this one that will happen on the 28th of June. The event is called CML Lady of the Ring Lucha Fiesta Number 2. She faces against the champion Dark Silhouette. So it's a very interesting thing. I think Unagi had some comments towards that. Let me look it up. I saved it on my phone recently. Let's see. Yes, here it is. This is what she had to say. She talks about her opponent. About her opponent, of course, Dark Soleta. Her ass is huge. After all, when you actually meet Mexican wrestlers, they are huge. They have long careers. I know they're great. They are great. But I still want that belt because a strong person belt, after all, it's a perfect for a tall wall I'm standing in front of. I have a secret plan as well. So, I don't know what she's planning on, but yes. Now, those who know this, Unagi is the current Kitsune world champion for the Kitsune Women's World Women's Wrestling. She was announced, of course, she will be part of the Sugo event. But later it was announced that she will be participating in the following month for the Yabai show. And I'm not sure, I don't think they announced who she'll be wrestling with for her title. But yes, so that event will take place on August 18th, I believe. So we're looking forward to that. So I think that's pretty much it with her upcoming matches and all this. Let's, of course, talk about some interesting developments that she's been involved in. All right. Other developments that Unagi Sayaka has been showing, been doing. Well, when she's not wrestling, as you know, she has a tendency to invade other promotions. And one of those promotions has been Evolutions. Now, as you know, Evolutions is an Ayoshi promotion that was originally a project that was meant for wrestlers to appear in All Japan Pro Wrestling, but things have not been going well recently with them due to the fact the president made a decision to align themselves with At-Risk Girls. But, however, Unagi auditioned to be part of this promotion, but eventually was kicked out because of Suwama. And of course, Unagi, on the other hand, made an appearance saying that she wants to be the producer of Evolutions. But Chi-Chi, who, as you all know, I mentioned countless times that she's a prospect of the promotion. She has been very successful here and there. She doesn't believe that she's in it for that. But Unagi even criticized Evolutions, saying she won and passed her audition. But she's not there all the time. Why can't you kick me out? But she's not there. So she does have a valid point there. We have seen many wrestlers. Now, not to criticize Momoka Nozono. I mean, she is a fantastic wrestler. She is a terror in the ring. But the thing that I think it was overlooked about Momoka, those who know this or not, Momoka will not accept any bookings unless the promotion comes to her turf, which is, of course, Osaka, Japan. That's where she's originally from. That's always been what she does. She always takes bookings in Osaka. And I often say, why can't she just expand her brand? And Unagi does have a valid point. I mean, it's not like, you know, oh, she's wrong, but that's what happened. So she got kicked out, was thrown out, but that's how it went. So I don't blame her for feeling that way, but she does have some valid points, and that's something you can't take away from. Now, recently, as you all know, she also said she would like to join MARIGOLD, but for some odd reason, instead of Hatman saying that he's okay, he decided to go through the audition. You know what? I started to think maybe Hatman had something to do with the idea of her being fired. You know, that's the thing. I mean, why have her go through the audition? You have Suri who's not going through the audition. You know, that's another thing that I kind of questioned it. But I wouldn't be surprised if she does show up. I mean, after all, she is a freelancer. So is Suri, and so is Nagisa Nozaki, who both of them are also freelancers. So I don't know why Rossi's saying go through the audition. So we'll see about that. You know, I feel like Hatman is being unfair. But we'll see. But I think we are done with everything with Unagi Sayaka Watch, so I say it's time to call it a day. Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Before I go, I think some of you may question about when I said Hatman on the Marigold update with Unagi. I was referring to Rossi Ogawa, so that's because people call him that. You know, I only say that because, you know, if he's not doing something wrong, right, I call him Hatman. But if he does something wrong, right, I call him by his name. So just to clarify for all of you on that. But yeah, so there'll be another Unagi Sayaka Watch somewhere down the line, but I like to apologize for holding this a little longer. I was, like I said, I was caught up with other things for this channel, and somehow it kind of put on the back burner for a little bit. But because I mentioned earlier on the special announcement, I got that out of the way, so no problem, no fuzz, no muss. But until then, on the next Unagi Sayaka Watch, so we just have to wait and see what happens from here on out. So I'll see you guys next time. So I must bid all of you adieu. So goodbye. Mwah. And have a nice day. Bang.